you've got even more competitors this time. If you're at 19, maybe 20, I'll have to double check. You've got like two or three people still need to get registered after you get done. No problem. So you've got plenty of time. You've got the drive. I'm probably going to try to get qualified right at 6, maybe 5, maybe 5. I'll have to tell you we've got later. We'll at least get a few laps. Most importantly, while there, people are still trying to get the stuff right. Let's go to the drive.
Transition together.
Some people are going to naturally e-brake right here. As a chase driver, you have to be ready for that. What we're watching for as judges is a constant flow and a constant speed throughout the entire course, including the S. Okay? So once we get this transition off the touch and go section, the best section on the track, when you get it right, I'm going to do it right now, one out of three times. Okay? It's supposed to be difficult because it's a competition. When you get this transition right, the flow through here is incredible. I mean, it just naturally takes you all the way to the end. We have an area right at the wall where I give everybody an opportunity to make a mistake. Okay? Nice. Love it. So, whenever you come through this line, it's all together, especially as a lead chase driver, be mindful. You can hit this wall before you finish the finish line. That's still a zero. What we're looking for is minimal contact throughout the whole run, whether it be with the lead driver, whether it be with the wall, etc. So, clean lines. If you have to sacrifice angle into a zone to make a cleaner run, that is going to make you more successful today. Like, the most fluid driver that makes it look effortless around the track is probably going to win today. So, any questions so far?
Where's the point of no return?
Point of no return. Very good. I would say the point of no return is going to have to be outside of zone one. Now, what we're doing different this time as well is I'm going to get everybody a called restart. Doesn't matter if you're leading or chasing. You know, if you make an error before the point of no return and somebody doesn't call a restart, you're able to do it once. Not once around, once today. Say, hey, I need a restart. No problems. This is casual. We're super serious. Everybody's competitive. This is casual, man. Everybody's back here sharing information, tuning each other's cars, sharing each other's tools. You guys, you know what I mean? We're laughing and hanging out together. You know, that's what it's all about. So, we're going to find out who's taking on the hardware today. I expect this to be even better than round one. I expect round three to be better than round two. So, we're going to try to bring the heat. What's even more important to me is after we get this done, I get to drive all the lights out today. Other people that just started driving with the lights off, it's kind of difficult, but it's really good with them all. Any questions about where you're going to be judged, how you're going to be judged, Chris?
Is there going to be a limit on one more times?
No, there will not be a limit on one more times. I do not expect there to be an obstacle with that today, especially with how technical the track is. Once you leave the starting gate and initiate, you shouldn't straighten out the entire course. The only place you're even close to that is whenever you're leaving here to kind of do that, you know. And other than that, everybody should be sideways the whole entire time, and that's what we're looking for.
I was chasing this distance.
Great, great. Glad you brought that up. Even better point. People that are more familiar with Formula Drift, the zones aren't even there. The zones here are for qualifying. Whenever you're a lead driver or a chase driver in a battle, the zones go out the window. And what I mean by that is, if you're a lead driver, you want to drive the best line possible, which is the qualifying line. But if you're the chase driver and your lead driver is not driving the qualifying line, you cannot dictate by staying in the qualifying line and still get the proximity you need. So if you're a chase driver and the person in front of you is taking the wrong line, it is your job to follow him into the wrong line, okay? And proximity over everything as a chase driver. Proximity over everything, over angle, speed, proximity over everything. second to proximity would be matching their angle. So as a chase driver, you want to match their angle no matter if they're running the wrong line or not. Okay?
Are you going to dock the lead driver for being so far out of line?
That's exactly what I was getting to next. So there's a thing called an unchaseable lead. So I'm probably the most known for that here. I drive a lot by myself. When you do that, you want to just get out as far as possible. That's not always giving your opponent a fair shake at following you, okay? So in this case, I don't think anybody here is going to have that problem. However, cutting it too shallow would be a place where an unchaseable lead will come into play. For instance, if you come through this zone and you decide I can't get out there, I'm gonna cut it right here. Well, the guy chasing you, he's gonna, you know, crash. So I don't see that happening too much, especially with the drivers we had. Everybody's been, you know, running outside the lines. Closing the door is gonna be kind of only applicable for this session and for this session. So I don't really see that being an issue. I really want to stretch it out, to be honest with you guys. To make you guys do it both directions, that'll be for a different event.
Are you going to have failure to initiate for the chase driver?
Say it again?
Are you going to have failure to initiate for the chase driver?
What do you mean by that?
Heading back too far, not getting in the line.
Well, that's where proximity comes into play. That's why proximity is main goal. Angle, matching that angle with the lead car. So you're going to be judged against each other. So when I say let the zones go out the windows, the camera battles, if you are having problems making this X, but if you do it a different way and it works great for you every time, and you get where you want to be, run it that way. Let it be up to the judges to determine if you're doing it. That's why I said, if you're an advanced driver, you don't necessarily need to pay attention to the exit, but they're there to help you if you're new.
If a chase driver makes contact with the lead driver, that's
something that we usually go over as well, just to bring that up. As a chase driver, it's your responsibility not to make contact with the lead driver. 95% of the time, it's going to be the chase driver's fault. However, especially in this zone, you have to pay attention to your opponent. If he checks up real hard out here, you've got to be prepared for that. You know? It'll have to be case by case scenario of how the lead driver comes. And that's why I was saying, especially going into the zone, checking up is going to be not as, it's going to be more frowned upon. Straight transition, you know.
Let's say you're coming around this turn here as a lead driver, right? A chase driver bumps you and then he spins you out. Do you just take off, just continue on from there?
You might, yeah, I might even call a restart at that point, depending on how close it was, or a case-by-case scenario. If it's right in the first turn, and we can get a quick restart going, that we want everybody to complete the whole course. You know what I mean? And, you know, it's best scenario. All right, so that took a good 15 minutes.
So we're going to drive from down here this time.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so the judges. The judging table is right here. Okay? So I'm going to be, the three judges are going to have perfect view of everything. Look, it's like starting day, all the zones. So I'm not sure if anybody would be in the way. I don't think we'll be taking a space, but just right here. So the table will go right here, and you know, we'll be judging from here.
Where's the finish?
You got the finish to the zone, and you got to continue the drift. Whenever I'm out here, I'm almost already launching back across the finish line. Up to your discretion.
So this section of the course here is
not. No, sir. You can shut it down at the finish line. And if you're a chase driver, and your lead driver shuts it down, you run into it, that's ridiculous. Don't be hurt. Where are you going to park all the cars at? In the parking lot.
No. What do you mean? Park in front of the judges.
ocean. Oh, you're taking me down below. I'm sending her to come by. No, should I be scared if you stay or go? Tell me I'm insecure, just overly emotional. Have I fallen down? No, no, no. Searching for things I'll never know. Searching for things I'll never show. I guess I just don't wanna let go. morning go. We leave to keep slow. For us it's fun and go. For us it's all we know. It's fun and go. We think ahead out of force out. We run and go. For us it's in our phone. It's run and go.
Right now, my heart is full.
What you like?
Or LIFO.
Be like bacon. Nikes on my feet make my cypher complete. I stay shining like the lights on the street in the night. Remus take me shopping when I'm up in New York. Hit the shoe store, go and cop a few more. You at the mall getting dinner at the food court. I'm in LA eating 22 course. Young boss bitch, paper in my pockets. I got a closet filled with shoe boxes. I'm my spending habit, little bit obnoxious. But a pile of steak fresh up in the hand-me-downs. Now buy some clothes, wear them out. Hit the club, bitches, pull their cameras out. Living in a dream, they beginning to believe. My hotel smell like cigarettes and weed. Shit, with what I'm spitting, they should give me a degree. Good liquor, what I'm
saying. Alright, you guys all that was super stuff. I don't even do this comedy, so I made a track. So I can do it. And I was up with 24 people. We had 20 competitors here tonight. People that didn't want to compete, competed for me. So we can make this happen for everybody. Okay, we put a whole lot of work into doing all the tracks. A lot of these guys here stayed extra, came in extra, so everybody had a good time. And everybody drove extra, so we had a good time. Zach Abernathy took home third place. Okay. Owen Northcutt took home second place. Let me have you guys stand in front of the podium so we can take some pictures. Let me
do it. No, no.